Today we are going to start numericals on spur gear. First numerical, that is for spur gear, pressure angle 20 degree, rated power transmitted 10 at 1440 rpm. Then service factor is given 1.5, gear ratio I is given 4:1. Material for gear, steel material, both gears are made by same material, that is steel material with SUT 600 MPa, that is Newton per mm square. Factor of safety 1.5. Design, spur gear for velocity factor is in account. Take ZP is equal to 18, number of teeth on pinion 18, ZG 72, Y 0.484 minus 2.87 upon Z, velocity factor 3 upon 3 plus V. This data is given in the numerical. You have to design spur gear. You have to design the spur gear. Now, there are four steps from this. First step is beam strength. SB is equal to MB sigma BY. This is for the spur gear. MB sigma BY. Now, here M is unknown. B is taken as 10 into M. It is vary from 8M to 12M and take the intermediate value, that is 10M. Now, sigma B, that is permissible bending stress, it is nothing but SUT upon 3. SUT is 600, therefore 200 Newton per mm square. Y, for this Y, equation is given 0.484 minus 2.87 upon Z. Consider number of teeth on pinion, because both gears are made by same material, pinion is weaker. Take 18 by using this, find out the value of Y. By calculation, the Y is 0.3245. Now put all these value in this equation. SB is equal to M into 10M into sigma B is 200 into 0.3245. Find out the value of SB, that is beam strength. Find out the value of SB, that is beam strength. By calculation, it is 649 into M, that is M square. The unit is Newton. It is strength, therefore unit is Newton. It is in terms of M square. This is the beam strength. Now, second step, that is wear strength. But the wear strength is considered when the BHN is given in the numerical. In this numerical, the BHN is not given, therefore neglect the value of BHN, that is wear strength. Now, second step here, that is effective load. Second step is effective load. By considering the velocity factor, P effective is equal to CS upon CV into PT into CA. Now here CA, it is not given in the numerical, therefore you have to take the value of CA is 1. CS, it is given in the numerical, that is 1.5. For CV, you have to consider the equation 3 upon 3 plus V, which is given in the numerical. Now for this V is required. V is find out by using the pitch circle diameter, but here model is unknown. Therefore, initially velocity is taken as 5 meter per second for the spur gear. It is taken as 5 meter per second for the spur gear. Therefore, CV is equal to 3 upon 3 plus 5. This is nothing but 3 upon 8, that is 0.375. This is the value of CV, that is velocity factor. Now in the numerical, torque transmitted is rated power is given. Therefore, first find out torque transmitted. MT is equal to 60 10 to the power 6 into kilowatt. Kilowatt is given 10 upon 2 pi into NP. NP is given 1440 rpm. Find out torque transmitted MT. By calculation, 66314.56, this is the torque transmitted in Newton mm. Torque transmitted is nothing but 16 into 10 to the power 6 kilowatt upon 2 pi NP. Kilowatt is 10, NP is 1440 RPM, already given in the numerical. Now find out the PT, that is tangential or static load. PT, it is nothing but MT upon RP, that is DP dash by 2. This is nothing but MT is 66314.56 upon into 2 upon DP dash, that is M into ZP. M, ZP is 18. M is unknown. Find out PT, that is the static or tangential load. This is 7368.284 upon M. It is load, therefore it is in Newton. It is load, therefore it is in Newton. Now find out the effective load. P effective, CS 1.5, CV 0.375, PT 7368.284 upon M into CA 1. By using this, you have to find out the effective load. This is in terms of M, and it is load, therefore it is Newton. And by calculation, the value of this is 29473.136 upon M Newton. Upon M Newton, this is the effective load. Now the next step, to avoid the failure, SB is equal to P effective into factor of safety. SB is equal to P effective into factor of safety. SB is 649 into M square is equal to P effective 29473.136 upon M into factor of safety. It is given in the numerical, that is 1.5. From this M square and M, left hand side M cube and all constants are in right hand side, calculate that constant and find out the value of cube root of that constant, that is M. This M is 4.08 mm. This M is 4.08 mm. Now you have to select the first reference value by using choice 1 series. That is, you have to remember three values: 1, 1.25, 1.5, then multiply by 2, that is 2, 2.5, 3, multiply by 2, 4, 5, 6, multiply by 2, 8, 10, 12, multiply by 2, 16 and 20. This is the first preferred series for the module, that is choice 1. Now from this table, you have to select the first reference value. After 4.08, the next value is 5 mm. Therefore you have to select M is equal to 5 mm. This is the first preference value for this numerical, 5 mm. Now after getting the value of module M, you have to find out the standard dimension. In standard dimension, module M is 5 mm. Phase width B is taken as 10 into M, that is 50 mm. Then pitch circle diameter, DP dash for pinion, M into ZP. M is 5, ZP is 18, that is 90 mm. DG dash, that is M into ZG. M 5, ZG is given 72, it is 360 mm. Now initially we have considered the velocity V 5 meter per second. Now here the value of DP dash is known, therefore find out velocity V. V is equal to pi into DP dash NP upon 60 into 10 to the power 3. Pi into DP dash is 90 into NP is 1440 upon 60 into 10 to the power 3. By using this, you have to find out velocity V. Now this velocity V is 6.79 meter per second. Initially, we have considered 5 meter per second. Now by calculation, it is 6.79 meter per second. After calculating these dimensions, you have to find out the velocity factor first. CV is equal to 3 upon 3 plus V. V is here 6.79. Therefore, CV is equal to 0.3064. This is the value of CV, 0.3064. Then find out SB. SB, it is in terms of M, 649 into 5 square. M is 5, therefore 5 square, 16225 Newton. Then PT, it is also in terms of M, that is 7368.28 upon M is 5. Find out this, 1473.656 Newton. This is the PT. Now find out effective load again. P effective, CS upon CV. CS is 1.5. 5 upon CV. Here CV change, that is 0.3064. Initially V is 5, now here V is 6.79 into PT. PT is 1473.656 into 1. CA is 1. Find out the value of effective load. This effective load is 7214.37 Newton. This is nothing but the effective load. Now again, to avoid failure, SB is equal to P effective into factor of safety. Here SB is 16225 is equal to effective load is 7214.37 into factor of safety. You have to find out this factor of safety for bending, that is beam strength. This factor of safety, by calculating this, it is 2.25 and the given value is 1.5. That means this calculated value is greater than given, therefore your design is safe. Your design is safe at module M is equal to 5 mm. That is, it is safe at first preference value module M is equal to 5 mm. Like this, you have to solve the numerical for the design of the spur gear. Okay.